As more churches were built by the Augustinians, Franciscans, Dominicans, Jesuits, and Recollects, the need for silver ecclesiastical objects grew in the late 16th to the 19th century.
The Filipinos, though excellent goldsmiths, were not familiar with silversmithing, perhaps because silver was not popular, for it tarnished quickly. Just like in the case of religious painting, the friars had no recourse during the early 17th century but to rely on expert silversmiths from China. Chinese artisans valued silver very highly, preferring it to gold because it was the standard currency in China. All the early objects were simple and relied on forms and proportion for their beauty. Designs and processes became more sophisticated toward the second half of the 17th century.
Filipino silversmiths, descendants of the first Chinese artisans who had by now intermarried for generations with Filipinos, and were mostly based on Quiapo, were adept in all aspects of the silversmith trade. They produced masterpieces and mastered gilding and plating. These are sacred vessels that are essential to each parish because they are used in sacraments. Before any church interior, furnishings funds are allocated to produce these sacred vessels first.
Chalice, where wine and water is placed for consecration, and its accompanying pattern, where the big host is placed for a consecration. Ciborium, where the consecrated hosts are stored. They are kept inside the tabernacle if not used for communion. Holy oil container, used for anointing. The one with the sea on the lid is for chrism, for the sacrament of confirmation, and the one with the cross on the lid is for anointing the sick. Pyx, a host container that is used for giving communion to the sick who cannot go to church. Cruet's chest. Cruets are separate containers for wine and water consecrated into the blood of Christ. They are kept in these chests. Host container. Similar to the purpose of a ciborium, but in a space-saving design so many can fit into the tabernacle. Baptismal shell. Used to pour holy water on the child being baptized. Host maker. Portapas or portapax. Bears a religious image which is kissed by the members of the congregation during the portion of the Mass where the priest bestows the peace of Christ. Aspergillum and aspersorium. Aspergillum, a liturgical implement used to sprinkle holy water on the congregation. Aspersorium, a bucket or vessel to hold holy water. Incensarium, container in which incense is burned, typically during a religious ceremony. Incense boat contains the incense, usually is accompanied by a small spoon. Communion plate, used to catch a consecrated host that fell off accidentally or crumbs of it during communion. Monstrance, used for the exposition of the Blessed Sacrament. We usually see this during the procession of the Corpus Christi. Relicario, or reliquary, used to expose the relics of a saint or a holy object. Contains a relic of a true cross. Contains the bones of Santa Lucia.
The burgeoning plantation economy of the 19th century brought in a prevailing air of civic pride that swept the towns.
Each vied to have the most beautiful church in the province, so that towering main altars glittering with 23 carat gold leaf became the norm. Larger and richer towns, wanting to make a statement, sheathed their altars with bead and silver, a project that involved a lot of time and kilos of silver coins.
50 pesos usually went into every kilo at a time, when the price of a sack of rice was 1 peso and a carabao cost 20 pesos.
The first to be made was the tabernacle where the sacred host was kept. It usually resembled the facade of a miniature temple or church, replete with columns on bases and tablatures and a pediment with a central doorway. Next to be made was the altar font or frontal, which usually needed 20 kilos of silver coins with a value of 1,000 pesos. Sometimes a rich man would finance the cost of the whole frontal in order to have his name engraved on it for posterity to remember. This silver frontal is made using the isot or isod technique. It is achieved by engraving a metal surface by using a V-shaped chisel to cut a wavy line along the design, also known as wriggle work engraving. This frontal is made using the pokpok technique, where designs are beaten into the silver. In this technique, the silversmith needs to flip the sheet of metal many times to emboss and put details. Flanking the tabernacle that stood at the middle at the back of the altar would be a pair of graded receding steps or platforms called gradas or gradillas, also overlaid with silver. Silver candlesticks, usually weighing a kilo each, and vases of flowers were arranged on them. The former always came in a set of six. Two were used for the regular mass, four for a high mass, and six for a mass on a holy day of obligation. On the feast day of town's patron saint, however, there was no limit to the number of candlesticks used, and the entire retablo was ablaze with light up to the ceiling. Since fresh flowers were rare or obtainably only during certain seasons, some churches opted to have them made of carved, painted, and gilded wood or of silver.
These ramilletes, literally bunches of fruits and flowers, were designed to decorate the altar the whole year round.
A large sacra, or mass card frame in silver, was placed against the tabernacle door, while a smaller one on either side was placed against the center of each set of gradas, sanctuary lamp. A light in front of the reserved sacrament, consecrated by bread and wine, left after communion service to signify and honor the presence of Christ in the elements of bread and wine. Some churches decorated the alcove where the town's patron saint was kept with silver. During fiestas, the alcove is framed by a silver arco or
baldaquino.
We see here the festejada of the Intramuros Grand Marian Procession, the Immaculate Conception, framed by a silver arco. The head and hands are made of ivory. Sometimes, images of the Virgin Mary are furnished with a plancha de plata or silver frontal, composed of a skirt and a breast piece. This one, worn by the Immaculada, is a contemporary piece.
Vestments worn by priests and deacons complement the splendor of the main altar with all of its silver accessories.
These heavily embroidered vestments usually come out on special occasions only. The richness of the design symbolizes the dignity of the minister of the sacrament. The casulla or chasuble is worn only by the priests. This design is called the fiddleback, locally called as the guitarra because it is shaped like a guitar. This was the form of the chasuble that was in fashion during the height of the Spanish colonial period. The dalmatica is worn by deacons and acolytes. Usually, the dalmatica and the casulla come in a set with similar design. Among the precious furniture inside the church sanctuary is the bishop's chair. It is a grand chair, rich in carved ornamentation, usually gilt and upholstered. This chair came from Bulacan and was made around 1860. The seats of the co-celebrants of the Mass are placed on either side. The main altar is the focal point of the church. It is the treasury of some of the highest form of sacred art. It also serves as a gallery for Filipino talent.
From silversmithing to wood carving to embroidery, the sanctuary is saturated with examples of great Filipino craftsmanship.